Hey, what's up guys? Today we're gonna create a scene in Marmoset Toolbag 2. We need to export this model first, and after we exported this model we can import it in Toolbag. I made some changes to this model. I've separated this in a few parts, like the chassis, the tracks, the rebels and the windows, because this model uses a few separated textures and I want to keep it easy for myself. So let's get started. We need to export this model. Export. I'm going to call it GLA truck. You have to be sure you have checked these settings. These have to be checked, this one. And these settings can be unchecked because you don't need it. And yeah, let's hit export. Now it's done. We can move over to Toolbag and import the mesh into Toolbag and get started with that. So now we are in Toolbag, we can import our mesh by clicking File and Import Mesh. Select your object, press Open, and there we have it. As you can see, there are no textures on it because you need to apply new shades with the textures with it. And we're gonna create them with this one, the Dota 2 template. I choose this template because I like the style of it. So we're gonna select our normal map. That's the one that creates depth. And we're gonna select our diffuse map or albedo map. It's the texture with all the colors on it. You're gonna select a reflectivity map or a specular map. And then we can drag it on our chassis. As you can see, it works okay. Need a bit of optimization. You can always do that. By options you need to click 16. So it's at the best resolution. And yeah. Duplicate this one. I'm gonna do the tracks now. Drag it on your tracks. There we have it. Duplicate it again for the rebels. My rebels doesn't have a specular map, so I click none. Move them in. And let's do this and bring the intensity now and refreshing all down. Now we need to create the windows. Just duplicate it, drag it to this one. And because I have the alpha map already in my textures, I only have to do is change the transparency. I do add, and there we have it. Windows are reflective and transparencies. And what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna change the sky to a sky I like. Go to presets and play around with these settings. I think this one will do the job for me now. I bring the background down because I don't want to see it now, and start playing around. What I do need to do is change the axis of the normal map, because does look a bit strange to me. So I'm gonna flip the eye. Looks better. I'm going to do that with these two. Here we have it. And yeah, you can see it's just a model with the standard lighting. So we're going to change the lighting, the effects, everything of it. We go to the camera, because the most settings are there. You can change the fuse of fuel if you like to. Exposure settings, more contrast. If you like contrast, you're gonna bump it up, sharpen a bit. The brightness of the bloom, the size of the bloom, the vignetting is not working now because I have a black background, and you can see that because vignetting is black. I'm going to add some grain because I like that. You have to keep in mind you can play with your settings yourself, because everyone has his own desire. So I'm gonna do my own. I'm gonna click some depth of field and change it a bit. Gonna add some distortion, chromatic aberration, makes those weird colors. Looks like you need to wear 3D glasses, but I like it. And we're gonna do some settings on the shadows, local reflections, high-res shadows, ambient occlusion, and front-facing shadows. I like to get the strength up and change the size a bit. This looks nice. So there we have it, a better looking render in real time. I'm gonna change the blur on the front. Looks great. I like it. You can also change the lights, how it falls off. I like to have a dark, warm tone. It fits the Middle Eastern house styles. I'm gonna play around with the sun. This looks great. So what it can do now is export it as a image file, and I like to set the resolution to 1.2 and capture our screen. back because it eats GPU. As you can see, we have our screenshot of the model. We can also create a turntable so it rotates if you like to do that. The only thing you have to do is this. And capture a turntable. This will take a while because you need to render all images. And you can combine all those images together to create a video or animation or what you like to do with it. Let's wait a bit. Now it's done. You can see a folder here and it has a couple of images in it. As you open them and fast forward, and you can see it rotating. You can put all those images together and stitch them and create a video of it, and you have a turntable of your model. You can also change the preset again to another one. Or you can choose your own image. I don't have one right now, so I'm gonna select the presets and do these ones. Get some more depth. Capture the image. There we have it. So yeah, I hope you liked this video. I like to teach people things that I like to do. Yeah. See you next time.